Hello, all you amazing healers. Today I'm going to talk about, again, abundance, but let's talk about, are you giving your energy to abundance or scarcity? So I'm going to, in the next few minutes, I'm going to talk about ways to avoid giving your energy to scarcity and ways to bring in abundance very easily. Okay, stay tuned to hear more. This is Anastasia. I used to be a physics professor specializing in vibrational and quantum physics. After recovering from a serious illness using energy healing on myself, the calling to heal became so strong that I had to quit my 40-year research career. I replaced my six-figure professor salary within 5 months using a simple but not easy three-step system that I worked out to grow my healing practice. Now I help other healers grow their practices, whether they're just starting or already have a practice, with this same three-step system. I'm all about helping you too. Listen in to learn more. Thank you so much for coming back. Let me get my notes out. So, are you giving your energy to poverty? So let me give you a few examples of what that might look like and what will happen when you do. So when you are continually thinking about not having enough money, you will attract people that don't have any money to pay you. So let me give you an example of this. So if you are writing a book about how to live on a shoestring budget, for example, and this is a true example of what happened with one of my entrepreneur friends, is that he wrote how to, you know, advertise on a shoestring budget, how to build your website on a shoestring budget. What ended up happening is that he thought he would attract a lot of clients and that he could, you know, charge him a reasonable amount of money. I'm not saying he wanted $5,000 per client, but I mean, even $500. And he said nobody was willing to pay it because it wasn't on a shoestring budget, right? So imagine you're attracting people that are on a shoestring budget. So I wrote a really brief little book that I belong to a little coaching program that allows you to write these little books. And I wrote this book on attracting abundance into your life. And then I started thinking about it and somebody says, so you're writing a book about abundance. Now, who would be attracted to abundance? And I thought, oh no. So I never published that. The reason why I'm doing these videos on wealth blocks is that a lot of healers have wealth blocks. We get told that you should give away your stuff for free. We get told that healing is a gift. Why are you charging? That healing comes from God. Well, everything comes from God. Your intelligence, your beauty, your health, the world, butterflies, birds, it all comes from God. So that doesn't make any sense. So why should anybody be charged for any of that, right? So we get it in our heads because we get told over and over again that that we need to not charge because we are helping to make the world a better place. Well, everybody who's doing their part, trash collectors are helping make the world a better place, right? People that make beautiful cars are helping make the world a better place. Hairdressers are making the world a better place, although I don't go to one. I got my own hair. You can tell, right? So anyway, so when you are continually thinking about not having enough money, like you're looking at your bank account and going, man, there's not enough in there to pay all my bills. I really need to make my next sale to help pay those bills in my, that I have on my credit cards. And I a long time ago stopped thinking about that because I kept thinking, well, if I'm thinking, look, you need to sign up with me so I can pay my bills, then people are going to get the message that all you want of them is their money, right? So the next one is, when you are continually angry about something, you will attract angry people. And this is also a true story. I met this woman. I can see through it. Like, people have put a facade on and I can see through it. So it wasn't hard to see how what a sweet woman this person was. But outwardly, she was angry. And I, in the beginning of my practice 10 years ago, I offered free half-hour healing sessions at these live events I went to. And she took me up on it. And I did a healing on her. And so then she did some sessions with me. And during the sessions, she revealed to me that she had an immune deficiency, and meant that her bone marrow didn't produce enough gamma globulin. She had a gamma globulin deficiency called gamma globulin anemia. I had never heard of it until that point. And she had had it for 27 years. And so then I asked her, I said, you know, I sense that you really need to do a healing with the energy of your father. And she says, I've been angry at my father for 27 years. Interesting. And and so I did, I talked with other people since, after I did that clearing. Her business opened up dramatically when in the first month, she, without doing any new advertising, improved her bottom line by about 30%. And she got very excited about that. But the interesting thing isn't that that happened. The interesting thing were, because we had attended the same events together over the years, the interesting thing was that the people that we knew mutually, when they first met her, they always said, she's scary, she's angry. And so the people that were calm got repelled, and the people that were like agitated were attracted to her. So it's not that opposites attract, it's that likes attract. And putting out that energy, people match it. And so it's just like two magnets. The south ends want to come together. Well, the south ends will repel. Sorry, I got mixed up there. But I'm thinking that it's not that opposites like magnets attract. It's that like people attract because they resonate with one another. It's like two tuning forks that are tuned to the same frequency. If you tap one, the other one will ring at the same time. And that's exactly how it works with us. We are attracted. So if you are anxious in any way, you will attract anxious people, because people that aren't anxious don't know how to deal with anxiety. They don't understand it because they don't realize you can't help it. They don't realize that they don't have to fix it. They don't realize that no matter what they tell you, it won't fix it. So they just don't know what to do about it. And, you know, anxious people, I learned from dealing with my mom that all she wanted was a hug, right? So when she was anxious, I would just hug her. And I didn't say anything, and I didn't try to fix her, and I just tried to listen to her, right? So people that are anxious will attract other anxious people because they understand one another. So instead of thinking about trying to get rid of something, right? Like, I don't want to attract poor people, right? Then you're going to attract poor people. And there's nothing wrong with that. But let's say you are, you're thinking, I really need money. And then you end up attracting other people that really need money if you are in a business. And my own feeling about it is, Even though I have credit card debt, if I wanted to, I could dig into my retirement account and just pay the whole thing off. I have plenty of money. So in my opinion, I feel rich. So why am I doing all these? Because I love to help people. It's just always what I've done since I was very young. And when I was very young, I didn't get paid for it. I would go around and help all my classmates get their math done because they didn't understand it, and I did. And I knew how to do it, and I was very fast at it. So it's just in my nature to do that. And it's also in my nature to teach things that I've learned along the way of life, right? So then the last thing is, okay, so now instead of giving energy to poverty, how about giving energy to abundance? So one of the things that I do regularly, not nearly enough, is I imagine my energy field growing, right? Because your energy field is out about the extent of your arm span. If it's in a relaxed, normal state. If you're in a fearful state or if you're ill, it pulls in really tight. And so what we want is to have it out there. And the larger your energy field is, the more it can contain, and actually the more generous you feel, right? So what I usually do is when I'm breathing, right? So I'm deep breathing. And as I'm breathing, every time I breathe in, I imagine it expands. And every time I exhale, it'll come in a little bit. But I just keep imagining it pushing out further. And one of the other things that you can say is all the times and all the ways I'm totally receptive, because you're receiving whatever it is. Love, health, wealth, it doesn't matter. All of those are energy, and they're all wealth, in my opinion. So let's do it together. Right? Expand out, pull it in, and now say all the times and all the ways, I'm totally receptive. All the times and all the ways, I'm totally receptive. And every in-breath, you push out all the times and all the ways, I'm totally receptive. All the times and all the ways, I'm totally receptive, right? And now as you are expanding outward and upward, you are creating a larger energy field to help you contain more energy. And this also allows you to get into the abundance mindset. Instead of thinking lack, you are thinking abundance, because you're growing your energy field that's around you. And as soon as you start growing, you become more abundant, not bodily, but energy-wise. Okay, I hope that was helpful today, right? Don't give energy. Instead of giving energy to poverty, you're going to give energy to abundance. You're going to imagine your life as much more abundant. You certainly don't want to, you want to put attracting poverty, attracting angry people, attracting anxious people, although I as a healer want to help those people. But if you are in a business, for example, of wanting to help others, then having all of those thoughts will also repel them, right? Like I said, people will start thinking that you want them for their money. If you're angry, just like my former client, if you're angry, you will repel people. And then when people started to see that she was actually this very warm, kind, loving person that had some bad breaks early in life, as soon as she did that, her business started to increase, and she was a bookkeeper for business owners, right? So that is... you know, these are lessons that we learn along the way. And instead of focusing on what you don't want, focus on what you do want, because whatever you focus on grows. Okay, thank you so much for listening. I will see you in the next video. Thank you so much for taking valuable time out of your day to listen in. If you found this message helpful, please help spread the word by giving the broadcast a thumbs up or a 5-star rating, share it with your friends, and be sure to subscribe to my channel with your notifications on. For further training on healing and growing your healing business using my 3-step system, go to www.highpaidhealers.com, and I'll see you in the next video.